This episode of Science in Real Life is coming to you from far above Cayuga's waters. That's right, we're back at my alma mater, Cornell University, for an exciting collaboration with the Boyce Thompson Institute's NSF Research Experience for Undergraduates Summer Program. The National Science Foundation supports REU programs in all areas of scientific research at sites around the globe. They provide funding for all undergraduate participants so that they can fully immerse themselves in research projects for an entire summer. But enough for me, four awesome undergrads are going to tell you all about it.
Heard about the REU program through another undergraduate in my lab at my home institution, and I was really excited to hear that REU offers funding both in terms of a stipend for research work and a place to live, so it just makes the entire experience very easy. And one other component of REU that really jumped out at me was that there's so many areas to specialize in terms of research that might not be available at someone's own institution. And so for me personally, I was able to jump into a topic that I really loved that I wasn't able to study at all at my own school.
How I got involved in research is that I first went online to my school's biology faculty website, and I made a note about the few that I was interested in and sent those people a personalized email to introduce myself and talk about why I was interested in the work that they were doing. And it kind of went from there. So I think it's great that we have these great resources at my home institution, but I have great opportunities elsewhere, like this REU at BTI as well.
I was really excited to apply and get accepted, and the program so far has been amazing.
Dr. Van Wyck's lab on protein degradation in chloroplasts, the photosynthetic part of the plant cell. And because proteins are so instrumental in cell growth and development, our findings will help us better understand the chloroplast's role in plant growth.
My project is in Dr. Fei-Wei Li's lab, and I study the evolution of hornworts, which are close relatives of mosses. We're culturing them in the lab to sequence their DNA and assemble their genomes to hopefully identify the genetic basis of some of their unique traits.
I'm in Dr. Mueller's lab building a web program that'll allow users to visualize genetic data of two sweet potato relatives with the goal of helping breeders select traits that'll improve sweet potato crops.
This
summer, I'm working in the Giovannone lab, where we focus mostly on tomato genetics. My project specifically is on what exactly causes tomatoes to start ripening, with the end goal being that if we can understand the genetics behind this process, we can apply that to agricultural practices and have tomatoes that ripen with appropriate timing for good sale and consumption.
As an undergrad, there's a lot of people you might work with in the lab who might serve as mentors to you, such as the PI, which stands for Principal Investigator. The PI is typically a professor of the institution. They oversee all the projects going on in the lab and all the different members. They help secure funding, and they're really awesome.
It's true.
Or a postdoc, which is a postdoctoral researcher or someone who has finished their graduate degree and is now working underneath the PI on an independent project.
Or a grad student, who's somebody that's currently working on their PhD in their field of study.
One of the most important skills in research is having patience, because experiments take a very long time to progress. So while we're here for the summer, we are contributing on smaller projects that'll be part of a larger project that'll one day result in a publication or a paper. And the reason that it takes so long is because there's a lot of troubleshooting and problem solving that happens in research.
Yeah, sometimes you might not know why an experiment's not working, and that's kind of a time when you can go reach out to other lab members and collaborate and try to fix the problem or figure out what the problem is. Other times you might just make a mistake, like adding the wrong reagent to a reaction, or you drop something, spill something. These are just things that happen in everyday lab life, not really a big deal, even though it might feel like it at the time. It's just kind of when you, you know, take a break, go treat yourself maybe, and then come back and start over.
All right, so what was everyone's favorite part about this summer? Arianna?
I think my favorite part was when we got to tour the DICE lab and learn about bees and their pollination and the diseases affecting them. And I really liked getting to wear the protective gear because it looked really cool. What about you, Kendall?
Ooh, I really liked the class that the REU program offered, the bioinformatics class. I just thought it was so interesting to learn about all of the new skills and computational work that I had no idea even existed in my field of study. How about you, Siobhan?
I really liked getting to meet a bunch of new people and just explore the surrounding area, you know, go on hikes, visit the waterfalls, visit the farmers market, and just capitalize on the free time we had on the weekends and weekday nights. How about you, Victor?
Yeah, in addition to the research, my favorite part, I think, was all the guest panels we had about different topics, like different career paths in science and how to apply for NSF funding and grad school, as well as the weekly seminars we had to hear about BTI faculty talk about their ongoing work. And what was even better was the free lunch we had after each seminar.
Yeah.
Very good.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hey!
Just wanted to say thanks so much for sharing your experience with the REU program with everyone. I think it's going to be a really good resource for people who are looking into getting into undergrad research. And we've also included a bunch of links in the description to the NSF REU program and things like that if you want to know more. And don't forget to subscribe to Science in Real Life, and we'll see you next time.